Today we light the first candle of the Advent wreath. Each candle has a meaning. This first candle is hope. From Psalm 33, verse 20, we wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, as we await the coming of our Savior, give us the courage to hope. Help us to see your plans of redemption for our lives, for this community, and for the world. Through Jesus Christ, who is the source of our redemption. Amen. Good morning, and welcome to Holy Faith Episcopal Church in Inglewood, California. I am the Reverend Jennifer Wagner Pavia, and I'm glad that we are gathered to worship together on this, the first Sunday in Advent. This starts the new church year called C, goes A, B, and C, and this is C, in the church calendar. So I also wish you a happy new year too. You'll find a link to the bulletin for the service below in the comments and on our website at holyfaithinglewood.org. And today is also Youth Sunday. So please welcome our young people into your homes and into your hearts. It warms my heart to be able to see and to hear them during the season of social isolation. We all miss you. I invite you to leave them a greeting in the comment section below. Buenos dias y bienvenidos a la Iglesia Episcopal Holy Faith Santa Fe in Inglewood, California. Soy la Reverenda Jennifer Wagner Pavia y me alegra que estemos reunidos para adorar juntos el primer domingo de la temporada de la Iglesia de Adviento. Esto inicia el nuevo año de la Iglesia en el calendario de la Iglesia. Así que deseo feliz año nuevo también. Encontrará un enlace a boletín en este servicio a continuación en los comentarios y en nuestro sitio web en holyfaithinglewood.org. Hoy también es Domingo Juventud, así que por favor denle la bienvenida a nuestros jóvenes a sus hogares y corazones. Me calienta el corazón poder verlos y escucharlos durante esta temporada de aislamiento social. Los invito a dejarles un saludo en la sección de comentarios a continuación. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen. Please join me in saying the Collect for Purity. Únase a mí para decir la colecta por la pureza. Dios omnipotente, para quien todos los corazones están manifiestos, todos los deseos conocidos y ningún secreto encubierto. Purifica los pensamientos de nuestros corazones con la inspiración de tu Espíritu Santo, para que te amemos perfectamente y dignamente, te celebremos la grandeza de tu santo nombre, por Cristo nuestro Señor. Amen. And now, continuing on, together we will say the song of praise. Continuando juntos, diremos el canto de alabanza. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. God be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Lectura del libro del profeta Isaías. Ojalá rasgaras el cielo y bajaras, haciendo temblar con tu presencia las montañas, como cuando el fuego quema las zarzas o hace hervir el agua. Entonces tus enemigos conocerían tu nombre y las naciones temblarían ante ti. Cuando hiciste cosas terribles que no esperábamos, cuando bajaste las montañas, temblaron ante ti. Jamás se ha escuchado ni se ha visto que haya otro Dios fuera de ti que haga tales cosas en favor de los que en él confían. Tú aceptas a quien hace el bien con alegría y se acuerda de hacer lo que tú quieres. Tú estás enojado porque hemos pecado. Desde hace mucho te hemos ofendido. Todos nosotros somos como un hombre impuro. Todas nuestras buenas obras son como un trapo sucio. Todos hemos caído como hojas marchitas y nuestros crímenes nos arrastran como el viento. No hay nadie que te invoque ni se esfuerce por apoyarse en ti. Por eso te ocultaste de nosotros y nos has abandonado por causa de nuestra maldad. Sin embargo, Señor, tú eres nuestro Padre, nosotros somos el barro. Tú eres nuestro alfarero. Todos fuimos hechos por ti mismo. Señor, no te enojes demasiado ni te acuerdes siempre de nuestros crímenes. Mira que somos tu pueblo. Escucha lo que el Espíritu está diciendo al pueblo de Dios. Demos gracias a Dios.
Oh pastor de Israel, escucha tú que pastoreas a José como a un rebaño. Tú que te sientas sobre querubines, resplandece.
In the presence of Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh, stir up your strength and come to help us.
Oh Dios de los ejércitos, restárdanos, haz resplandecer tu rostro y seremos salvos.
Restore us, O Lord, God of hosts, show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved.
Le diste de comer pan de lágrimas y beber lágrimas en gran abundancia.
You have made us the derision of our neighbors, and our enemies laugh at us to scorn.
Oh Dios de los ejércitos, restáuranos, haz resplandecer tu rostro y seremos salvos.
Let your hand be upon the man of your right hand, the son of man you have made so strong for yourself.
Por ello, nunca nos apartaremos de ti. Danos vida para que invocamos tu nombre.
Restore us, O Lord, God of hosts, show the light of your countenance, and we shall be saved.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you, because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Thanks be to God.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true. With thanksgiving, I'll be living sanctuary for you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord Christ. But in those days, after that suffering, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in its clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Be aware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn. Or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake.
Waiting Upon the Lord, a sermon by the Reverend Canon Whitney Rice. Waiting is the hardest thing to do because it feels like you're not doing anything. And it seems twice as hard when you're young. When we're children, Christmas always seems eons away, and we think the end of school or our birthday will never arrive. And we 21st century folks certainly have an ever-shrinking attention span. Our wealth and technology allow us to access virtually anything we want, anytime we want. Everything is sooner, faster, now. And boy, do we love that speed, especially technological speed. Wait 10 seconds to let a web page load? Are you kidding? Get a faster connection. Wait 5 seconds for a document to print? What the hell's wrong with this printer? Wait to let yourself cool down before sending that email or posting that social media rant. Are you kidding? Go, go, go. You snooze, you lose. That's our motto. If anyone needs to learn the Advent virtue of waiting upon the Lord, it's us. Virtually the only things we haven't been able to speed up or shorten are our basic biological processes. It still takes 9 long months to have a baby, whether we want that wait that long or not. And so, if we want to be with Mary in her journey toward giving birth to Jesus, we need to settle into the long haul. We've already been busy doing other things for the first 8 months. And now, in her last month of pregnancy, we're just going to have to take these 4 weeks of Advent and wait. Our scripture from Isaiah today has an interesting take on waiting. The writer is marveling at how different the God of Israel is from the other gods in the cultures of the time. And then the writer remembers, when you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down. The mountains quaked at your presence. From ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you who works for those who wait for him. The prophet is surprised not just by the mighty deeds like earthquakes. The writer is equally stunned that there is a God who works for the people. And the people for whom God works are the people who wait for God. What is it like to wait for God? Many of us know exactly what that is like. We wait for God to explain why a family member died too young. We wait for God to open a path out of a marriage that has ended into a new place where healing might begin. We wait for God to reveal an open door back into a faith community when we've been hurt by so many churches before. And of course, virtually this entire year has been a time of waiting. We've waited during lockdowns and quarantines. We've waited on masks and respirators and toilet paper. We've waited on test results for the coronavirus, wondering whether we are positive or not. We've waited endless weeks and months, not able to visit our loved ones in hospitals and nursing homes in order to protect them. We've waited on our kids going back to school and waited to see if our jobs would hold out during the crisis. We've waited on unemployment checks and stimulus checks. We've waited in line to vote and waited to see if our mail-in ballot went through, and then waited on the results of the election. We've waited for a vaccine, and we've waited and waited and waited to go back to church in the old ways that were familiar and comfortable to us. 2020 has been nothing but a year of waiting. Perhaps we are better equipped now than ever have been to understand the oft-repeated biblical mandate to wait upon the Lord. The good news shared with us today is that God is working for us as we wait for God. And we're actually doing two kinds of spiritual waiting right now. We're waiting for the coming of the Christ child on Christmas Day. that glorious moment of incarnation when God comes to be with us in human form. That's a fixed endpoint that we know ahead of time. Coming December 25th, we will be celebrating Jesus' arrival. But we're doing another kind of waiting. We're waiting for the signs of the incarnation in our own lives. We're waiting to see the new and next way that God will be manifest in our own individual time and place. God is with us, but where and how? This is how we keep company with Mary, as the watchful sentinels, always on the lookout for the new revelation waiting to be discovered among the everyday. Patience is a hard-earned virtue, and many of us are deeply wearied by all the waiting we've had to do. All the times we've had to say no to ourselves and our children this year in order to stay safe and keep others safe. It might feel like 2020 is a year out of time, a wasted and empty expanse that consisted of nothing but life on hold. But is this true? Was this time of waiting really wasted? Mary's time of waiting was almost as long as ours has been. What has been blossoming and growing in your heart during this time of waiting? What new thing is ready to be born in your spiritual community after having been forced to slow down and really ask what is most important about church? How has your family found new strengths and graces by the call to adapt and the sudden multiplication of time together and new challenges with work and school? Mary's time of waiting was to a purpose. It had a goal and an end, and she faithfully pursued it with God's help. As you reflect on your waiting this year, what has God grown in you? What will be the gift you offer the world this Christmas, as Mary did? It takes awake and alert eyes to see the grace even amid the suffering we've endured. But the good news is that the slow, necessary, at times painful work of being changed, of being made ready for incarnation, is not up to us alone. God is the agent of our transformation as we wait, knowing what reminds us that we don't have to figure this out on our own. There is peace and comfort in the truth that as the endless days of waiting crawl by, God is active within us and our communities. Isaiah tells us in our scripture today, "Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you are the potter. We are all the work of your hand." We are God's work of art, being painstakingly shaped into the vessel of incarnation that will bring the presence of Christ to the world. You are a masterwork, and masterwork takes time. And Paul reminds us of what we most need to hold on to through the long, weary days of waiting for grace. You are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end. Look back on this year and see the strength with which you endured its trials. See the creativity with which your spiritual community sought to walk together in new ways. See the call to justice and peace that rang even through our most bitter divides in society. And know that it has all led to this, the season of Advent, the time of upheaval and waiting, of change and pause, of grace and truth. And so we pray, and we stick together, and we love one another. We wait upon the Lord. And Isaiah, the great prophet of the Advent season, announces the good news. Those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Amen.
And now together let us affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. Juntos afirmemos nuestra fe en las palabras del Credo de Nicea.
Creemos en un solo Dios, Padre Todopoderoso, Creador de cielo y tierra, de todo lo visible e invisible. Creemos en un solo Señor Jesucristo, Hijo único de Dios, nacido del Padre antes de todos los siglos, Dios de Dios, luz de luz, Dios verdadero de Dios verdadero, engendrado, no creado, de la misma naturaleza que el Padre, por quien todo fue hecho, que por nosotros y por nuestra salvación bajó del cielo, por obra del Espíritu Santo se encarnó de María la Virgen y se hizo hombre. Por nuestra causa fue crucificado en tiempos de Poncio Pilato, padeció y fue sepultado, resucitó al tercer día según las Escrituras, se subió al cielo y está sentado a la derecha del Padre. De nuevo vendrá con gloria para juzgar a vivos y muertos, y su reino no tendrá fin. Creemos en el Espíritu Santo, Señor y Dador de vida, que procede del Padre y del Hijo, que con el Padre y el Hijo recibe la misma adoración y gloria, y que habló por los profetas. Creemos en la Iglesia, que es una santa, católica y apostólica. Reconocemos un solo bautismo para el perdón de los pecados. Esperamos la resurrección de los muertos y la vida del mundo futuro. Amén. Let us pray for the church and for the world. In the hushed anticipation of your coming, O Lord, remind us that you are always with us, and that, like Mary, we may say yes to fulfill your will as we pray. Come, Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
O God, in days to come, the mountain of your house will be established, and your joy shall reign. We pray for the church, for our presiding Bishop Michael, our diocesan bishops John and Diane, for all laity, deacons and priests, that you teach us your ways, that we might walk in your path. Come, Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
De Sion saldrán instrucciones y tú, oh Dios, juzgarás entre las naciones. Oramos por nuestra nación en nuestro tiempo de profundas divisiones y por todas las naciones, para que su paz se manifieste en cada rincón de la tierra. Ven, Señor Jesús. Escucha nuestra oración.
In the fullness of time, O God, you sent your Son to be born of our sister Mary, and his name was Emmanuel, God with us. We thank you for your presence with us, and we pray that you might be always be present with those whom we love but see no longer. Come, Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
En tu reino, oh Señor, los lobos se acuestan con corderos y los niños juegan con serpientes sin miedo. Oramos por los enfermos, los que sufren y los que sufren cualquier tipo de angustia, que sanarías todas las heridas, consolarías todas las penas y resolverías todos los errores. Ven, Señor Jesús, escucha nuestra oración.
In your kingdom, O Lord, wolves lie down with lambs, and children play with serpents without fear. We pray for the sick, the suffering, and those in distress of any kind, naming them silently or loud. We pray for those who in this season of hope and joy can find no hope or joy. We pray for those who are sick from COVID, the newly diagnosed, those who are in hospital, those who care for them, those who love them. We pray for those on our own congregational prayer list of holy faith. We pray for Geraldine Brown and her healing. We pray for those for whom the holiday season brings pain. We pray for those feeling anxious and depressed during COVID. We pray for all the youth who are either studying at home or a combination of home and school, that they may stay healthy and safe. We pray for their mental health, for their emotional health, and also for their spiritual health as they navigate these new waters. That you would heal all injuries, comfort all grief, and settle all wrongs. Come, Lord Jesus, hear our prayer. O Christ, our Savior, hear our prayers. Restore us, redeem us, and show us the glorious light of your countenance, that we might be transformed to love as you love. Come, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Señor, y ten piedad del mundo.
Good morning again, and I thank you for this digital time together this morning. If you are visiting or new to this service, you can find more about us at holyfaithinglewood.org, and I invite you to leave us a note and your name in the comments below, and we will get in touch with you. You will find a letter from me on page 12, called Transforming Generosity, as our season of stewardship continues. Your commitment to supporting Holy Faith in our ministries is crucial, especially in these challenging times. And we still have much in this congregation to be thankful for. The link to the online giving is in the comments below. And the links to all of our weekday meetings and services are on the website in the weekly update and on page 13 of this bulletin. All of those links you just have to click on. If you want to receive the weekly update, please leave your email below in the comments or register for it on the website. And please keep this congregation and our transition team in your prayers in their ministry of discernment during our clergy transition. You will find that prayer in the bulletin as well. Please contact Giselle in the office or let me know directly if you need help or you need pastoral care. I am always here for you. And tonight and on all the Sundays in Advent on Facebook Live, we will light our Advent wreaths together. And I will follow that with reading an Advent children's book. I hope you can join me for this weekly opportunity to gather in that space. Please visit the Holy Faith calendar at the end of this bulletin or on our website for other ways to connect with each other throughout Advent. Thank you.
Buenos días otra vez y les agradezco por este tiempo digital juntos. Se está de visita o es nuevo en este servicio, puede encontrar más sobre nosotros holyfaithinglewood.org. Y lo invito a dejarnos una nota en los comentarios a continuación. Encontrará una carta mía en la página 12 titulada Transformando la Generosidad a medida que continúa nuestra temporada de mayordomía. Su compromiso de apoyar a Holy Faith en nuestros ministerios es crucial, especialmente en estos tiempos desafiantes. Y todavía tenemos mucho que agradecer en esta congregación. El enlace a las donaciones en línea se encuentra en los comentarios a la continuación. Los enlaces a todas nuestras reuniones y servicio de lunes a viernes encuentran en el sitio web, en la exhalación semanal y en este boletín. Si desea recibir la actualización semanal, deje su correo electrónico a continuación en los comentarios o regístrese en el sitio web. Por favor, mantenga a esta congregación y nuestro equipo de transición en sus oraciones por su ministerio de discernimiento durante la transición del clero. Encontrará esa oración en el boletín. Y por favor, comuníquese con Giselle en la oficina o avíseme si necesita ayuda o cuidado pastoral. Esta noche a las 6 en Facebook en vivo, iluminaremos nuestros coronas de Adviento juntos y lo seguiré leyendo el libro infantil de Adviento. Espero que puedan acompañarme en esta oportunidad semanal de reunirse en ese espacio. Visite el calendario de Santa Fe al final de este boletín o en nuestro sitio web para conocer otras formas de conectarse durante el Adviento. Gracias.
Que Dios te bendiga con quietud mientras escuchas la palabra. Que Dios te bendiga con paciencia mientras observas la luz. Que Dios te bendiga con anticipación mientras esperas amor. Que Dios te bendiga con la alegría del cielo mientras te regocijas en su nombre. Y la bendición de Dios Padre,
Hijo y Espíritu Santo, esté con ustedes hoy y permanezca con ustedes siempre. Amén.
Soon and very soon, we are gonna see the